I'm Chris with Splunk Education. In this video, we're going to examine the Splunk Search Job Inspector. It's a useful tool when you need to troubleshoot or tune your searches. The Search Job Inspector provides a window into what happens when you click the search button, giving you a place to see where time was spent fulfilling your search, including the behavior of knowledge objects in your environment. The Search Job Inspector can be used with any search job that has not expired. There are two ways you can access the Search Job Inspector. From the New Search view, we can expand the Job menu and select Inspect Job to open the inspector in a new browser window. Alternatively, if you know the search ID, you can use it as a URL parameter with the Job Inspector Manager endpoint. Any user with the proper permissions to see the search will be able to inspect it, which can be helpful if you need another set of eyes when troubleshooting your search. At the top of the window, we see the current status of our search job. This will look different depending on if the search job is running, paused, or completed. This job has finished, so we see how many events were returned, scanned, and how long it took to complete the search. Knowing the events per second, or EPS for our search, will give us a quick way to know how well our search is performing. To find EPS, we divide the events scanned by time it took to complete. A well-performing search should run at roughly 10,000 EPS or greater. Any messages returned from the search subsystem will be displayed next. Here it looks like an administrator has disabled a lookup table definition, but an automatic lookup that references it is still in place. We'll make a note to fix that later. Next, we see the search ID and a link to the search log. Clicking on search.log, we can see everything that happened to fulfill the search. This log can come in handy when we need to dig deep into the steps Splunk took to return our results. The Search Job Inspector splits information returned under two sections: execution costs and search job properties. Information in the execution costs section will help us troubleshoot the efficiency of our searches. It allows us to discover how processing components are affecting our search. The search job properties section provides information about the search job. There are more components than we can cover in this short video, but we will highlight a few that are important to understand in this search. Under execution costs, we see a table including the time to process each component, the component name, number of times the component was invoked, and the input and output count of events for the component. Items nested under the command.search component represent processes that were run concurrently to fulfill the search. Components used will change depending on the requirements of a search. The command.search.index component tells us how much time Splunk took to read the TSIDX files and know what raw data needs to be read. It uses tokens in our base search to find the events to retrieve. Command.search.rawData is the time it took to read events from the raw data files. Command.search.filter is the time taken to filter out non-matching events. The time spent applying field extractions can be seen under the command.search.kv component. We also have components that represent time taken to process knowledge objects, including field aliases, calculated fields, tags, and lookups. Looking at command.search.typer, we can see that a large amount of time was spent processing event types for this search. When an event type is processed, a key value pair for the event type is appended to any event that has matching values, which can take some time to process. Returning to our search, we'll append a command to only return the fields we need, eliminating some of the event types that need to be processed. Notice in the field sidebar that our search now only returns results from the two specified fields. Opening the Search Job Inspector again, we can notice a couple of things. we can see the time to process event types has dropped drastically. We also notice that since we are doing less field discovery, our processing time for field extractions has gone down. Execution costs to dispatch our search can be found under the dispatch components. They are very useful when working in a distributed environment where knowing the execution costs across search peers might be critical. Under search job properties, we can see characteristics of our search, including the time the search was created, the number of events and event fields scanned, status of search, and result count. Again, there are too many individual characteristics to explore in depth, but let's take a look at some of the more interesting ones. You may have noticed earlier that this search isn't written as efficiently as it could be. Here, we are searching an index, returning all results, and then searching those results again. Thankfully, Splunk does a little magic in the background to optimize searches for us. Looking at the optimized search property, we can see that Splunk has changed our search to search both index and source type at the same time, saving us from using multiple costly search commands to get the data we want returned. If you're new to Splunk, this can be a great way to learn how to optimize your searches before hitting the search button. When a search is run, results are written to disk and sent back to the search head. If there's a large amount of data required for the search, the time to move the data can impact search speed. The disk usage property lets us know how much space this search is taking up. Currently, we're only discovering and returning the fields required for our search, so disk usage is fairly minimal. But if we remove the fields command and inspect our search, we can see disk usage has grown exponentially, giving us yet another reason to always filter search results to only return the data we need. In a distributed environment, we will often want to know what search peers participated in a search to make sure our deployment is functioning correctly. We can see a list of instances that participated in the search by looking at the search provider's list. We have barely scratched the surface on all the information you can find in the Search Job Inspector. If you'd like to explore more of what this tool offers, check out the documentation link in the description below. And while you're at it, check out some of the other videos on our channel and register for education courses at splunk.com. Happy Splunking!